Lord, come upon us now. Release your power and let your presence fall. Lord, we proclaim,
Lord. Expressions of your love.
every day. Your name is the same. Our Lord, call your name.
Yeah.
Blessed Jesus, I love your name. I love your name, Jesus. Blessed Jesus, there is no other name I know. What a wonderful day, the day I will never forget. After I wandered in darkness away, Jesus, my Savior, I met. Oh, what a tender, compassionate friend. He met the needs of my heart. Shadow dispelling, and I'm telling you, he makes all my darkness depart. Heaven came down and glory filled my soul. When at the cross,
my Savior lived. My sins were washed away, and my mind was turned to day. Heaven came down, and glory filled my soul.
God right now. Begin to talk to God. I know we've been charged. We've been charged. Go ahead and begin to talk to God. The only food we can give God is just praise. It doesn't take anything from us. Just to worship Him. Just to honor Him. Just to adore Him. Just to reference Him. In the presence of God, there is the fullness of joy. Begin to talk to Him. Was done today. Heaven came down. And glory fills my soul. You see, when this meeting was coming up, normally we do it in November. But for one reason or the other, in my heart, my flesh said I wasn't up to it this year at all, for many reasons, which is flesh. And then in this church, we hosted a couple that came from Australia. And before we hosted that couple, God had been talking to me that, where is my worship? And in my heart, I was giving Him so many reasons why, Father Lord, you see the situation, you see me. And then the couple came, and it was announced on the altar that we can invite them, because they God told it, put it in their hearts to come to Ireland from Australia for the first time. They were elderly people. And so I hosted them in the house. And before they left, they hold their hand, both of them, elderly, Roger and Gwen. And exactly what God has been telling me over the week. That was the end of October. And God asks to Roger, where is my worship? That you have to do it. And the wife says, the question I was telling God, the reason why, the wife, which is Dave Gwen, answered the question that God said, I should tell you this. So I know it has to be done. And when I was waiting on God for what the meeting is all about, said I have to start putting in place in November. You know, normally would have done it 2nd November. But I started to start putting it in place in that November, and that's why God told me, okay, December the 16th. The first time we did the godly worshiper was in December the 15th. Saturday. So since then, it's been November, now December 16th. And he told me, I said, what this meeting is all about? He said, it's about my breath. That breath, my breath of the breath of God. Breath, the 1st of December, breath, what's the meaning of breath? I tell you, God has opened my eyes so much. Give me deep every single day since the 1st of December to this moment. God has given deep rhema, deep revelation to what the breath of life is all about. When I start getting that revelation, I quickly key into it. Because alas, the first thing for all of us is, without His breath, we won't be here today. Because He created us in dust. And before we can become alive, He has to be the breath of life. That's one. He gave us the breath. That's why we were able to be here. And then He took me again to the book of Genesis 1, 2. When God was about to create heaven and earth, you know, and then the breath, which is the spirit of God, have to go to what is known and void. The world was known and void, and there was darkness all over the place. And the Holy Spirit said, let there be light. So, I key into that, okay, the spirit, darkness, everything that is known and void. And again, that breath of God enter into dry bones and it comes to life. That breath of God is what we are celebrating today. Lord, when he visited Mary and told Mary that you are going to carry, a Messiah, the greatest gift we're celebrating. The poor girl say, how can this be? I'm a virgin. I never knew a man. And he said, the Holy Spirit will overshadow you. The breath of God will enter you. And the angel now put it there and was ringing in my head, there's nothing impossible for God. Breath of God. The breath of God. If the breath of God can go into Nazareth that had died for days, smelling, already in the hole, in the tomb, and be covered with graven image, and he came back to life, there's nothing the breath of God cannot do in our lives. So, today is the breath of God. Since then, I've been praying for single soul that are going to be partaker here. I don't know how God, what particular area that the breath of God has to enter into that person. But I know we all need that breath. We all need the breath of God. And no soul, even this church, no soul coming today that will not experience that breath. There is a living corpse. You know, people walk, but they're gone. But when the breath of life comes into things, it changed the situation. Job lost everything, but the breath of life entered. Not only God restored back everything that he has lost, he doubled it into 100 poles. That is the breath of life. So this moment, I just want to open up my mouth, your mind, to that breath. I want us to take it personally. That's what I tell the choir. I say, let's take it personally, because I want the whole world to see the breath of life in my life. I want them to feel that I experience God in a new dimension. I want my testimony to outlift me. Some people were saying their testimony today, their testimony outlived them. The man, the woman that touched the garment of Jesus, the hem, the breath enter. And whatever sickness gone, there's nothing God can do. We're not God. I don't know what it's going to do, but I just wanted to start key into this and begin to talk to God right now. Talk to God this moment. Let's invite that breath we're talking about is the Spirit of God. It's Holy Spirit. We cannot do without the power of Holy Spirit. Shekatarome akasatarome shenkiterebo. Zoketokia shaketoromo zekataramo shenerebo. Larekepokoso kitata. Lekerebo, I need to tell us this so that we can prepare our mind that it's not me that is calling us, it's God. Because this thing was put together within 3 weeks. Let's be honest. And during this early day, you know, but it has to be the voice of the Lord has to have gone. So guys, I want us to open our hearts right now and begin to talk to God. For the breath of life, the breath of God to enter, to overrun this place, over your hearts, over everyone coming up. There is a particular area in our lives that need that breath. Let the breath of God enter. We give God praise. We give God glory. We give you honor, adoration. Thank you, Jesus. We give you praise. Take all the glory, God the Father. Okay, I'm just going to go ahead a little bit so that we get some people in. Solomon, so we say, we have no power of our own. We have no realize this and say, I am no strength of my own, strength of my own.
I have no strength of my own. Holy Spirit, I look up to you.
I look up to you. Of my own,
I have no strength of my own.
Strength of my own,
I have no strength of my own. Holy Spirit, we look unto you. Help me,
I have no.
Faithful are you, Lord.
We are saying,
faithful are you, Lord. Faithful are you, Lord. Faithful.
We are saying, oh Lord.
Faithful are you, Lord.
I am saying,
faithful are you, Lord.
Faithful are you, Lord. Is there faithful, Father? Faithful are you, Lord. Faithful are you, Lord. Faithful. Faithful are you, Lord. We are saying.
Let's just be in attitude of worship. Let's just give God all the praise, all the glory, all the honor that belongs to Jesus. Let's begin to worship him, give him praise.
How majestic is your name, oh Lord, in all the earth. Your name is strong and mighty. Your name is glorious and great. In him we are saved. The name of Jesus, higher than other names. King of all kings, no other name like this. The name of Jesus, higher than other names. Alpha and Omega, no other name like this. The name of Jesus, higher than other names. like sweet perfume poured upon my soul.
Call his name, Jesus.
Call his name,
Jesus.
Oh, 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 oh. Mashiach, Lion of Judah, Agune Chembao, Yeshua, Mashiach, Lion of Judah, Agune Chembao, sing Yeshua.
Beautiful.
God, you are. You never let me down. You never let me down. I love you. What a mighty God you are. You never let me down. You never let me down. I love you. Say, what a mighty God.
What a mighty God you are.
I love you. casting crowns, lifting hands, say bowing hearts, it's all we've come to do. Adonai, say Adonai, Adonai. Sing it, Adonai, Adonai,
Adonai,
Adonai,
Adonai,
you reign on high,
you reign on high.
Say we will rise,
we will rise,
say we will rise,
in your name, Adonai, you reign on high.
Sing casting crown.
You are mighty on your throne.
are mighty on your throne.
You 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 are mighty. You're mighty on your throne. You're mighty on your throne. You're mighty in this place. You're mighty on your throne. You're mighty on the throne. Yes, you are mighty on the throne. You are mighty in this place. You are mighty on your throne. Jesus, you are highly lifted up in this place. You are mighty. You are lifted high in this place. You said if I believed it all, I would draw men. Can we just begin to continue in that atmosphere and just release our worship language? You are mighty in this place. You are mighty, Rabani. Eshona da 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 Erabakosia, is it celebrating an Amazubra Hande? Is she not a paria? Is that a Ibaruza? You are mighty in this place, King of glory, is mighty. Oh, Jesus, get us, O Brahanda. Oh, we wait on you, Lord, we wait on you. Sweet Holy Spirit, we wait on you, Lord, we wait on you. Holy Spirit, we wait on you, Lord, we wait on you. We wait on you. Shekinah glory, we wait on you. Holy Spirit, you are welcome. Fill this temple with your presence. Holy Spirit, you are welcome. Fill this tabernacle with your glory. We wait on you, Lord, we wait on you. We wait on you. The scripture says those who wait on the Lord, they renew their strength. We are here to renew strength. We wait on you. Choir sing. Lord, we wait on you. We wait on you. Lord, we wait on you. We worship you. We worship you. Oh, let us worship our King, Lord. We worship you. We worship you, Lord.
We worship you.
Lord, we worship you. We reverence you. We reverence you, Holy Ghost.
Lord, we reverence you.
We reverence you.
We reverence you,
Lord.
We reverence you.
Oh, we adore you.
We adore you.
We adore you, Holy Ghost.
We adore you.
We adore you. We adore you.
We adore you,
sweet Holy Ghost. Holy Spirit, welcome, welcome, welcome. We make room for you. Holy Spirit, welcome, welcome, welcome. Let's welcome him.
Holy Spirit, welcome, welcome.
I learned something. I was at a retreat last week
And one of the women of God said something. God is everywhere, but his presence is not everywhere. And that thing hit me. We have the breath of God. Everyone in this whole world has God breathing in them. It's God's breath in everyone. Because the scripture says, and he breathed into them. Not just the Christians. He breathed into them and they became a living being. So we all have the breath of God. But not everybody walking around is conscious and carrying his presence. So when we say we welcome you, that's where acknowledging that you are here, you are in me. So I like to sing so that we have a picture of what we are singing. It's not just a song. We are truly welcoming him. Oh, Holy Spirit, welcome. Welcome, welcome, Holy Spirit, welcome, 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 Holy Spirit, welcome, 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 Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, welcome, we welcome you. God of all language. Amen. Hey, Cabo.
Ah!
Just worship him. Open your mouths and worship him yourself. I cannot worship. I cannot worship him for you.
Almighty God, we worship you.
Almighty God, we worship you.
Present in resurrection, I worship you.
Almighty God, we worship you.
The one that breathed life into me, I worship you.
Almighty God, we worship you.
I worship you. I worship you.
Almighty God, we worship you.
I worship you, Lord. I worship you.
Almighty
to release our voices in here without the instruments. Like, can we just all sing it? Spirit of God, we worship you.
Almighty God, we worship you.
Let him hear your voice. Spirit of life, I worship you.
Almighty God, we worship you.
If you know that he's the one that breathed into you this morning, worship him.
Almighty God, we worship you.
As I was preparing this morning to come, the Lord reminded me, because I don't usually get the opportunity to attend many programs, and he reminded me of why I was coming to this, why he released me to come. And you know, the title of this program says Breath of God. And it reminded me just last month, my daughter just did her graduation from college. And that same night, as we finished at the graduation, that same night, I was feeling like out of breath because I had issues with asthma. But as we were finishing rounding up, I knew I wasn't okay. And I was struggling, but obviously with people around, you're still celebrating. But as I stepped out of the hotel, and just even getting into the car was work, and I started struggling to breathe. I couldn't breathe. I was looking for the inhaler, couldn't find it. I have so many inhalers, all of them disappeared. And I was just singing in the car, trying to get home. And I was just like, God, you are the breath in my lungs. You are the breath in my lungs. You know, I believe the spirit of Jesus is the spirit of prophecy. You know, sometimes he gives us a title. We don't know why. I keep saying some programs is for one person. And I feel like that's for me. You know, I was struggling to breathe. And all I could say, you are the breath in my lungs. You are the breath in my lungs. And by the time I got home, even the inhaler I found could barely work. It was, I could feel myself blacking out at this stage. And I was like, God. But you know how faithful this God is. He really showed up, that he calmed my spirit, that I was able to just trust him through that. It felt like 5 hours, but I don't know. It was probably just 30 minutes, but it was a long time being out of breath. That's when you know how precious it is to have this breath, when it's gone. But then the testimony of it, you know, that kind of hit me. You know, sometimes God does some things for us and we take it for granted. You just think, oh, you know, that's one of those things. And then that next morning, I have a prayer group that we, you know, we meet and pray every morning at 5 a.m. That same morning, we had to pray for one of our sisters. I was leading prayer that morning. And I was told to lead prayer for one of our sisters that the husband, at 1 a.m. that night, his life, his breath was gone. Same asthma. He went into hospital. They couldn't find a solution, and he was gone at 1 a.m. And yet, God, in his mercy, kept me. He gave me back that breath. I don't know. God is very strategic, you know. So sometimes when you attend programs, when you hear the word, we should never take, I fear God. After that, the fear of God really overtook my life, because I was like, who am I that God kept me? And yet one of us was gone. The same issue, but yet God in his mercy kept me. So I don't take for granted programs like this. They are prophetic. Don't be moved by the numbers. Don't be moved by anything. Because when God says go, there's a reason. There's a reason. And as I was in the shower just meditating and thanking God, when that thing came back to me, this song just kept on. You know, some of us, it's very hard to convince us to praise God, to worship God. But I can't worship God for you. And I've learned to worship God by myself without anybody. Amen. It's your breath in my lungs, so I pour out my praise. Pour out my praise. It's your breath in my lungs, so I pour out my praise to only you. Great are you, Lord. Great are you, Lord. Say it's your breath.
It's your breath.
Receive my worship.
worship. Oh, let me hear your voice. Make a covenant with him. As long
as I am breathing,
come flood these
Your presence, Lord. Sing your presence. Your presence, Lord. Oh, your sweet presence.
Your presence, Lord.
Oh, your sweet presence is all I want.
Your presence, Lord.
I just want to stay in your glory. We worship you, sweet Holy Ghost.
We worship you.
Bye.
a promise keeper. He's not a man that he should lie, not the son of man that he should repent. He's a covenant keeping God. He will never fail. The year might be running out, but Jesus is the God of time and season. He is Alpha and Omega. He is the Lord over time. He is the Lord over your season. He is a promise keeper. He is a promise keeper. Light in the darkness, my God. God and all about Jesus. But I love sharing, because sometimes when we sing, there are some situations that you face yourself, and it's God brings you a song of deliverance. He gives a song of deliverance. Our mommy here, you know, there was a season in 2017 that my son, he was only like a little baby, 5 months or so, and we ended up in hospital for so long. Mommy was here. She was there for me through that season. It was the worst 6 weeks of my life in Cork Hospital. But one of the things, when I talk about miracle worker, I saw God doing miracle. My son lost his sight in that process of everything that went on. He went blind. This was a child that could see, that could walk. He couldn't walk. He couldn't do anything. We were in hospital. Nobody could give an explanation of what happened or what they were to do. They tried all kinds of drugs. But my God, the miracle worker, he dumbfounded the doctors because they had no solution. But he... So when we sing, sometimes you need an experience to understand some songs, to have a revelation of some songs. That is who you are. That is who you are. Oh, Waymaker.
Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.
That is who you are.
Yeah.
If you have been blessed and that you know that the breath of God stir you up again, like Sister Veronica said, the breath of God is for everybody, but the Spirit of God is not for everybody. As far as we're concerned, the breath of God, the Spirit of God, and the Spirit of God is here. Every one of us that had been a partaker today, our life will never remain the same again, in Jesus' name. When the praise goes up, what comes in? Blessings, victory, healing, all sorts that we're looking for, God comes down for us today in Jesus' name. So I'm going to welcome us, and then we do the hymn, and again, we have the choir ministration, and then from them we take. So first I want to welcome each and everybody that are here today. Can we just sit down, please? Sit down for 1 second. We're going to, after that we take the hymn, and from the hymn the choir. No, choir, we're still standing. Choir, we're standing. Go back, soldiers of Christ. Soldiers, I am not soldier. Why didn't it? Come back here. God bless you, Pastor Cities. Also, first I just want to say honor everybody that I make it to today, to this. Like I said, it was a short planning. We would have done it, like I said earlier on, in November, because it's always come in November. But it was just a short planning this time around. And then on a day as this, the 16th, where everybody is kind of busy everywhere, people traveling, people do all sorts. And yeah, when the force of the voice of the Lord stirred me up again, from somebody that knew me, know from any Adams or know anything about me or this program, then I know that it has to be done. And so I want to thank everybody. The choir, we need you, and please keep your voice. So I welcome everybody. Mark, thank you for coming. Pam, thank you for coming. Mama, thank you for coming. Mama again, thank you for coming. And Brother Kevin, thank you for coming. And then elder, a pastor, the elder Hilton, thank you so much for being here. I thank each and everybody, the Living Waters Choir, for being here. God bless you. You said you'll be here, and you are here. I know, like somebody said to me, whoever that God has orchestrated that's going to be here, they will be here. I've already learned, God has taught me a lesson in that manner. When I was wild with people, he told me one day how many people were in the boats with Noah, 8 people. So from there, I resonated that whoever that God has said that is going to be part of it is going to be part of this. The word that God gave, which I said earlier on, is the breath of life. And it doesn't, you know, to human being, when I heard that word, it's like, what's going on? What, you know? But since the 1st of December, like I said earlier on, God had given me enough revelation when it's come to that word. More, when it's come to the word, the breath of life, which is so many things. And every single person, apart from that, we have the breath that we're living. There's so many areas of our life that need the breathing of God. There's so many particular areas of our lives that need the breath of God. In so many ways, God has breathed into 3 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes and make supplies to feed so many people. The bread of God that, you know, pathways for the Israelites to walk on the Red Sea is the same breath of God that destroyed Pharaoh and is in the same Red Sea. The breath of God that make this fire to be an air condition to Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego is the same. Is the same that destroyed those people that put them in the fire. The breath of God that sealed the mouth of lion. So that's when we talk about the breath of God. It's over our choir. We're taking him. Please, can we come back here? We're taking him. So it's the same, the breath of God that we're talking about. So today, I just want you to key into that word. There's a particular area in your life that we need the breath of God. Since I knew and God has told me, I had key into this, and I know next year, not only that how we come out to testify that testimony, but my testimony will speak for me. And so also everybody that are sitting down here. That